The second question says, arrange the following in ascending order. Okay, so you remember we have to, when we did ascending order, we are going up. When we do descending order, we're going down. So we're looking for the smallest number and we're going up to the biggest number. So that's ascending order. Now we understand the question and we must find the smallest number to the biggest number. So the first part, look at these numbers here, 0,301, 3,301, 3,310, 3,4, 33,013, and 3,41. Looks confusing when you look at it like that, but let's see how simple it is. First of all, we look for our whole numbers. So before the comma is your whole number, and after the comma is your decimal fraction. So here's all my whole numbers, and my first step is to arrange my whole numbers. So I want to go in ascending order. Okay, so I'm looking for the smallest one. So here's my smallest one. So 0,301 will be my smallest one. Then I have a whole lot of threes, but I'm not worrying about my decimal part of the fraction yet. So I'm just writing them in any order. 3,301. 3,310, 3,4, I have another 3 there, 3,41, and then I've got finally 33,013. So all I've done is looked at the whole numbers and I've put them in order from smallest to biggest. Now I must arrange my decimal part of my fraction. So now I'm looking at 301, 310, there's a 4 there, there's a 41 there, and there's a 013. So can you remember from the first question, what we're going to try to do is let them all have the same amount of decimal numbers. Okay, so this one has 3, this one has 3, this one has 3. Now this one doesn't have 3, so I'm going to add 2 zeros to it. This one has 1, 2, so I'm going to add 1 zero to it. And that one has 3 zeros, right? 3 decimal places. So now I can compare them, right? So obviously this number stays first because it's a zero, the whole number. So my first number is 0,301. Now I need to compare all the decimal fractions with the same whole numbers, which all have 3 there. Now I need to order them from smallest to biggest. So this one has 301. This one has 310, this one has 400, and this one has 410, right? So now 301, 310, 400, 410, but it's already done in order, right? That was just coincidence. You have to check it. So my order would be 3,301, 3,310, 3, now I added the 2 zeros, so I'm just writing 3,4 and then 3,41, and then my last number would be the 33,013. So let's just recap what we've done there. We look at all the whole numbers first, right? So you put your first, you arrange your whole numbers in ascending order. So we got the 0 here, that's the lowest number. Then we have a few 3s, so we don't worry about the decimal part. We just write down the 3, the numbers with all the whole numbers as 3. And then obviously 33 is last because it's the biggest number there, right? Then we arrange the decimal fraction. So we're looking at the decimal part of the question. And then I've added zeros to make them all have 3 decimal parts, right? There's 2 zeros. I added 1 zero there so I can compare them. Then I look at the decimal part of the question and then I arrange them in smallest to biggest. So 301, 310, 400, and 410. So then now I've arranged my question in ascending order. So normally we have just whole numbers. This question is about arranging the decimal fractions in ascending order. Okay, your homework for today would be exercise 7.3. It's on page 93. I'll put a picture of it. And then we have to mark 7.1 and 7.2 today. Okay, JazakAllah.